Business sometimes looks like this. The key to success is to be able to survive a hostile environment. Some companies have perfectly adapted, and where some are incapable of overcoming the droughts, others are used to it. They tap into their reserves, because that's the way to reap the rewards at the other side. The high-tech industry is like the desert caravan. It has to move on. Even when times are tough, high-tech companies will have to keep on investing large amounts of money before they can start picking the fruits of their labor. So how does the desert caravan do it? It has three secrets. It stocks up on water and food, it doesn't waste any of it, and it burns its energy where it matters most, movement towards the goal. That's how it reaches its destination.
Cofly is niet de enige partij die in staat is om een goede cleanroom te bouwen. Maar voor ASML zijn we meer dan alleen maar een cleanroombouwer. We zijn daar een bouwpartner. Van niets tot iets, vanaf het moment dat ASML besluit een nieuwe cleanroom te gaan bouwen, zitten wij aan tafel. Wij bedenken mee, wij budgetteren mee. Wij bouwen en valideren uiteindelijk een compleet gebouw met installaties en de cleanroom die erin zit. Op het moment dat ASML klaar is met de ontwikkeling van hun nieuwste generatie machines, zorgen wij ervoor dat de cleanroom benodigd om die machine te kunnen bouwen aan de specificaties voldoet en ASML in de gelegenheid stelt productie op te starten.
It takes conviction to spend hundreds of millions of euros on a new factory in the middle of the deepest economic crisis since the 1930s. A decade ago, ASML began researching the next generation of chip-making equipment, called EUV, for the light source that it uses, extreme ultraviolet light. But the biggest investment was yet to come. The company had to take a decision on building a new production facility, even as ASML's engineers were working to prove that EUV was ready to supply the world with chips. What was clear was that ASML needed a new building to make this new EUV machine, a building with more space and cleaner air. The exact requirements which the cleanroom had to meet were only finalized when construction was already underway. Theo Bartai, Senior Vice President, Manufacturing and Planning, only had a rough idea of the building that should be constructed.
By building it, also the projects came with newer moving targets on more electricity, more vacuum, and that lasted till 1 month before delivery of the building.
For the production of EUV machines, a much cleaner environment was necessary.
The EUV machine needs 1,000 times cleaner handling.